Good evening, and welcome to The Daily Show. We are back. This is our first show since the tragedy in New York City, and there's no other way really to start the show than to ask you at home the question that we asked the audience here tonight and that we've asked everybody that we know here in New York since September 11th, and that is, are you okay? And we pray that you are and that your family is. It's not a dream. But the aftermath of it, the recovery, is a dream realized. And that is Martin Luther King's dream. Whatever barriers we've put up are gone. Even if it's just momentary. And we're judging people by not the color of their skin, but the content of their character. And, you know, all this talk about these guys are criminal masterminds. They've gotten together and their extraordinary guile and their wit and their skill, it's a lie. Any fool can blow something up. Any fool can destroy. But to see these guys, these firefighters, these policemen, and people from all over the country, literally with buckets, rebuilding, that's extraordinary. And that's why we've already won. They can't, it's light. It's democracy. It's we've already won. They can't shut that down.
The comedian Jon Stewart returned to The Daily Show last night on a serious campaign.
It's Jon Stewart, everybody!
It had been 4 months since he was on this set. Stewart was here to shame Congress into reauthorizing health care funds for the men and women who responded to 9/11.
These first responders, many sick with cancers and pulmonary disease, have had to travel at their own expense to Washington, D.C. hundreds of times to plead for our government to do the right thing.
All 9/11 first responders.
5 years ago, Stewart had four first responders on his show. Last night, only one returned.
My feeling is, if you have stage four cancer and you get a letter of notification saying that the medicine that you rely on may be ending in a year, that to me is an urgent care situation. But again, I can't stress this enough. Why is it incumbent upon our first responders to have to consistently push to get the benefits that are coming to them purely for their acts of valor in a wartime situation? This is insanity. I refuse to despair as long as I see the heart and courage and dedication of the men and women standing behind me. Because there's no reason to. They can overcome. You don't understand. That was the thing that gave me sustenance that day, the thing that gave me strength that day, the thing that carried me through those terrible moments was the power and the heart of the first responders behind me. And it's still there today. Sadly, the only people who don't seem to see it reside on Capitol Hill. And it's time that they see it today.
A war of words that's no laughing matter, escalating between comedian Jon Stewart and Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell. The two men trading jabs over funding for the September 11th Victims Compensation Fund. After publicly shaming Congress last week, the former Daily Show host called out McConnell by name.
This has never been dealt with compassionately by Senator McConnell. He has always held out until the very last minute, and only then, under intense lobbying and public shaming, has he even deigned to move on it.
McConnell pushing back, arguing many things in Congress happen at the last minute.
We have never failed to address this issue, and we will address it again. I don't know why he's all been out of shape.
In response, Stewart joined his old pal Stephen Colbert last night.
I'm not bent out of shape. I'm fine. I'm bent out of shape for them. These are the first heroes and veterans and victims, and they're currently still suffering and dying and in terrible need. You know, you would think that that would be enough to get Congress's attention, But apparently it's not.
The feud sparked last week after Stewart gave a powerful speech that quickly went viral, berating Congress members who failed to show up for a subcommittee meeting to reauthorize the fund.
Sick and dying, they brought themselves down here to speak to no one. Your indifference cost these men and women their most valuable commodity, time. Certainly 9/11 first responders shouldn't have to decide whether to live or to have a place to live. They attacked America, and these men and women and their response to it is what brought our country back. It's what gave a reeling nation a solid foundation to stand back upon, to remind us of why this country is great, of why this country is worth fighting for, and you are ignoring them. They responded in 5 seconds. They did their jobs with courage, grace, tenacity, humility. 18 years later, do yours. Thank you.
McConnell offering this explanation about why the hearings are often empty.
Well, that frequently happens because members have a lot of things going on at the same time. And it sounds to me like he's looking for some way to take offense.
Stewart, I'm so snapping back.
And now I feel stupid. This is a huge misunderstanding. I didn't know that they were busy. I'm so, oh boy, now I don't even know what to say. I didn't mean to interrupt them with their jobs.
Later, imploring the Senate leader.
So, if you want to know why the 9/11 community has been out of shape over these past, let's call it 18 years, meet with them tomorrow as soon as possible and don't make them beg for it. You could pass this thing as a standalone bill tomorrow. Meet with them. I beg of you.
Before we do that, I found out just a little while ago, this afternoon, that the you guys know the 9/11 first responders bill that's been languishing in Congress for years, it just passed this afternoon. Yeah. Just got through. Finally. And one of my favorite things about this story is, here is, right here, give me a picture of that. There's Mitch McConnell right before the vote, walking in, knowing that he's gonna have to vote for it. And here's our friend Jon Stewart.
That's a good picture.
So, long overdue, thank you to the 9/11 responders for what you did for all of us. And thank you to Jon for staying on top of this.
Congress that can't agree on much of anything finally agreed on this.
97-2. 97. When does the Senate ever get that?
The bill ensures that the fund paying for medical treatments for first responders and neighborhood victims sickened in the aftermath of 9/11 never runs out of money. Former Daily Show host Jon Stewart has passionately championed the cause for years.
My job was to come in at the very end and yell as loud as I could, but it was all inspired by these guys.
The bill was held up by Republican Senator Rand Paul over spending concerns.
It's a manufactured crisis. As of today, the fund in question has $2 billion in it.
The vote came too late for former NYPD Detective Luis Alvarez to see it happen.
This fund is not a ticket to paradise.
3 weeks after testifying on Capitol Hill, Alvarez died of cancer. Son, David Alvarez.
I want to thank you for not forgetting him, not forgetting all the other first responders.
The bill now goes to President Trump. He's expected to sign it Friday while surrounded by 9/11 first responders.
The view from my apartment was the World Trade Center. and now it's gone. And they attacked it. This symbol of American ingenuity and strength and labor and imagination and commerce, and it is gone. But you know what the view is now? The Statue of Liberty. The view from the south of Manhattan is now the Statue of Liberty. You can't beat that.